Welcome to episode 2 of Shhh. Everybody says that motherhood is kind of the greatest job in the world, the best job in the world. I'm not a mom. I only mother children with fur and paws. But I've always thought these women who have the human babies, that's kind of like a secret society thing going on, right? I don't think they're really letting us know what exactly happens when you become a mother. So I have two girlfriends here today, and we have Yusra and Nalika, and both of them are not only just moms, both of them are actually empowered career women in their own right, but they have little monsters. So what are the tough things about pregnancy? The really tough things.
For me, it was even before I got pregnant, because I went through IVF for Nevan. So what they do is they fertilize the egg outside, right? And then like it divides and you can actually see it moving, and then they put it back into you. And when you get your period, it doesn't implant, and you get your period, it's like, gosh, it's devastating. And even before that, you have to get hormone injections. You have probes.
Did you do the injection yourself?
Yes,
what are the probes
I did.
Like? I'm really curious.
The probes are horrendous. Probes?
Nobody talks about this.
They're horrible. I can't even remember conceiving. Honestly,
do
I
do we actually conceive? No, I don't know. How do you know when you conceive?
you know before, right?
When
you're like
trying,
when your legs
right?
are up in the air and you're like waiting for things to filter down.
Correct.
So.
Yeah.
You have to give it some time when
what,
you're trying.
So what, you stick with your legs up in the air?
Against a wall.
Really? That's what, so they probe you and then you stick with your legs up in the air?
No.
Wait, this is the normal.
Not that
like,
probe,
normal.
The other probe.
Okay,
yeah.
So that's a little bit, doesn't it take the like the romance of the whole
thing? Oh, totally.
Totally.
Like, yes, you have sex and hang on, now I have to go put my legs
right.
up.
Yeah.
No, it's like move, like, you know.
Get out, no cutting.
Really?
Yeah, no. So then I eventually found out I was pregnant, and I still remember that exact moment. I was feeling very stressed, and when I'm stressed, I clean the house and toilets and various things.
It's a beautiful house.
Right. I was vacuuming. I clearly remember I was vacuuming. And then for some reason, I thought I must take a pregnancy test. And the pee on the stick kind. So I went and did it, and it was positive.
And I saved my first one with now when I found it a few days ago. I was like, why am I keeping pee sticks?
How old is your son now?
6.
So for 6 years, you've had a stick with your urine on it hanging around your house. My mother has I don't even know if Sri Lankanese know this, but she has my umbilical cord saved.
No, some moms do that.
It's the most disgusting thing in the world.
Some moms turn it into jewelry.
Yes. Some women love being pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, men say they love it when their wives are pregnant. Is that true? Because I heard conflicting stories also, like she is not the person you married when she's pregnant.
No, you look kind of glowy, etc. But inside it's like, you're
raging,
like waiting,
hormones.
You're waiting to like explode at someone.
Yes, usually the husband.
And what happens to your body? Like, yes,
oh my gosh, your body just...
Anything?
It's not only the stomach, right? It's the boobs, it's the...
everything.
The ankles swell, your arms...
Yeah.
Grow.
Yeah. Oh
your
my gosh.
And shoulders grow, your hips, like.
And
yeah.
then towards the end, like, I don't know, this happened with my third, like, you become loose, but then that's the whole body preparing for the birth process.
Loose, as in?
Like, ligaments loose, like, you feel like you're coming apart.
It's,
okay. So, you can
so that you can push your baby
process,
out.
So, yeah.
But it also makes you extra clumsy. That's the one that makes pregnant women really clumsy.
So you can't,
so,
like, be on your feet.
And the cramps. Did you get the cramps?
Yes, I did.
The leg cramps?
Yes.
That's very painful.
So it sounds something like I really want to go through. I hope we haven't alarmed any young women out there.
For me, I know most moms don't ask doctors about all these little things, and doctors don't tell you also because they're like running through their appointments and etc. So for me, like online really worked. Like I signed up with like this website called baby center and okay. like and
oh my gosh, with the second one my water bag broke in the taxi. This was in Singapore. So yeah, what happened was he was going over a speed bump and my water bag broke for the impact of that. And it was like, gosh.
And you were sleeping when you were broke.
Yeah, I was at home. I actually went down to the loo because I thought I needed to go. And then the whole thing just went and I started like shuddering and going into like active labor. And I had to yell for my husband. He came and he's like, what's going on? And I'm like, I'm covered in water. I just, it's coming. We need to go. I can't go anywhere. It's coming now. He's like, no, no, no. It's not coming now. You get into the car. And when we get to the hospital, he puts me on the wheelchair. And the wheelchair guy is like, which way is the maternity ward? Oh, and I'm like, you go this way, that way, that we get to the lift and it's on the second floor and da 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 da. And he's like, Danginoda. And I was like, yes, Danginoda. And I get 3:20. So that's in a span of 20 to 30 minutes.
With my second, 20 minutes.
Yeah, that's it I had. And then he came out.
So tell me about the first time. Okay, at least for the second time, you guys were prepared. At least you all knew.
No,
not really.
No, we weren't.
No, not at all.
You would have known what was happening or what to expect.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It was so fast, right?
It's 20 minutes.
20 minutes is crazy.
So, how long was the first one?
First one took forever. I was in labor for over 10 hours.
I was in labor for 5 hours because...
And what is labor like?
So, a contraction, it's like a period cramp. But it's like you've got this giant hand... kind of twisting your insides.
Like your muscles.
Yes, everything. That's what a contraction is like. Mm-hmm.
And it comes in like spasms. So it comes like, and then it gets closer, which is how they know.
And then it's just
out.
One giant contraction after that.
What's that experience of pushing like?
You feel an urge to push. It's like you want to poop.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I thought I needed to go.
Yeah.
They were like, no, you don't need to go.
That's what I want to talk about next.
The pooping while...
There is a poop situation in labor.
There is. But they give you it's a suppository, right?
Yes. Yeah. It's horrible. I poop.
No, the second one I yelled and I said, I need to go. I don't need to push out a baby.
I know this is disgusting to talk about, but I think I need to know. Right? So you poop and you're on your poop.
No, the nurses know what to do, but I was like...
So they've got sheets under you and stuff that they keep wrapping up and cleaning you and stuff. So
I was so...
You're basically sitting there with the legs wide open.
Right.
In a very dignified and ladylike
Extremely
manner.
Dignified. Very ladylike. Right? Yeah, very ladylike.
And there's like 10
and But I'm thinking at that point, you just don't care.
You're beyond caring anymore. Yeah. You just want
the
baby
whole
out.
Yeah. The circle of life. Right here.
It's just, that's just right. Get it out. That's it.
We have a name for our lady bits that we came up with. So we were thinking, you know, men name their whatever. Why can't we name our bits as well, you know, just so that we own them and love them or whatever. Let's call her Vajira. What happens to Vajira when you're giving birth?
Vajira kind of opens her mouth up.
10 centimeters. That's fully, so you dilate in stages. From 1 centimeter, you dilate to 10 centimeters. That's your cervix, right?
Yeah.
It's not the vagina.
Are your husbands watching this process? In the
they are.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they are.
And how do they feel about vagina opening your mouth 10 centimeters?
Horrified. Like, I remember my husband's expression was just like,
what is going on?
And then the guy is like, this is how you stitch it up. This is how the baby comes out. And I can see, like, nothing's getting into his head. He's just like,
with my first one, I remember so vividly the nurse, she was such a sweetheart. She thought I also wanted to see, so she held a mirror. Look, darling, look, you can see the head. And like my first, he kept coming out and going back, coming out and going back. I just remember yelling at her, telling to take the goddamn mirror away. I did not want to see this. And I have no memory of this, but my husband says that I yelled apparently then, get out. And this was at the baby and he came out, apparently. So that was that.
What happens to Vajira then?
Vajira is so sore. And
exhausted.
Stitched up.
Because they do like this cut. It's called the episiotomy.
They don't cut sometimes. I tore for the first one.
Abroad they do.
I know, I've heard this, but...
You don't feel
I
it.
Can't imagine you don't. What do you mean you don't feel it?
You don't feel it because your whole body is hurting.
How dare the world call a woman the weaker sex if they are going
they need
this.
To push out a baby and then talk about it. No, it's true. It's like women have super strength. Even like ladies who go through a C-section.
Yeah.
Like some of them go through normal or some of them are scheduled, like, you know, but then even then it's like you're cutting your tummy open to take a baby
it's
out.
It's major surgery.
It's major surgery.
Okay. So, right. Then why is it that you mothers tell us that giving birth is one of the most beautiful experiences?
It's a marketing tactic. It's definitely a marketing tactic.
Marketing for what? No, it's like, oh, we suffer, so therefore
everyone must suffer with us. Kind of, no?
Yeah.
Yeah,
no, but then it's like when you go through that whole process and like babies on your chest, which they do, and it's like, so cute. Yeah. No, okay. You know?
It's cliche, but it's true.
Yeah.
The moment you see that little, you know, the baby, the hurt stops, right?
Yeah, it stops.
Until later, of course.
The baby comes out, then the placenta comes out, and then you're like good to go.
So what happens afterwards to all those stitches, all that thing, you know, you've talked about afterwards.
Yeah.
So you're bleeding, right?
You're bleeding, you're stitched up, you're in pain, you have to go to the toilet, like you have to go, it's a thing, right? Like after having your child.
It's called the first poop.
The first poop. And it hurts.
It hurts a lot.
Yeah.
And you bleed, obviously you're now back to bleeding.
Yeah.
Back to bleeding. 9 months or not.
Oh.
And it's heavy bleeding.
Let's talk about, the bleeding, right?
Bleeding is like.
That is not period bleeding, it's waterfall, full on gushing.
So all this has happened, the drama, how long before you start feeling normal again? Physical.
Months.
Yeah. Years. Sometimes.
Yes, like 2 years.
Yeah.
Never. 2 years.
So you said when you're pregnant, you're very turned on and horny. Because your hormones are raging. Mm. But then suddenly your husband doesn't want to, you know, have anything to do with it. What does that do?
So husbands get into a weird protective mode, I think.
Yeah.
You know, when the wife gets pregnant.
Because for them, I think it's psychologically weird that there's a head there and I'm going to put something in there and the baby's going to know because the baby can keep moving.
Oh my god, what
does
the baby think?
Exactly.
Don't show the baby the probe.
Often they're severely overestimating their reach. Because the baby is sealed off from all of that. You know, the baby's inside your
like
womb.
A pouch,
and
it's
sealed. Your cervix is sealed. So they cannot see, they might feel.
Is sex better when you're pregnant? Is sex worse when you're pregnant?
I think it's better.
Because you feel like you're more, how should I put it, you're so sensitive?
Why I'm asking you this question is because in Sri Lanka, sex is something that we don't do as Sri Lankans, right? Sri Lanka doesn't have sex, right? About it with the Sanskrit and all, right? So in terms of like feeling horny when you're pregnant or wanting to have sex when you're pregnant is almost kind of like a shocker, you know, like... It's almost like chike. Because this pregnant woman is supposed to be this chaste, pure, you know, baby kind of.
Yeah, like how did she get pregnant in the first place?
Yeah, but then, you know, that mentality that I think women also put themselves into that.
Yeah.
Right? So.
But doctors tell you to have sex because, like, it eases the whole birth process.
It does.
Yeah.
What happens after birth?
I felt like, I always describe it after having them, they're superhero fans, right? Like Thor had taken his giant hammer and beaten me all over. That's how I felt with the first one.
Yeah.
With my first, my stomach muscles ripped this way. But breastfeeding is another matter altogether because they're just... So you might have one giant breast and one not so giant breast.
Amazing.
And then you've got the veins, you know, the blue veins.
Oh, it looks like you're something out of like an Avengers movie with the blue veins and like everything.
And
for me, I had engorgement, which was just a nightmare
from
day one.
So that is when your boobs get rock hard.
With too much milk. Yeah. And you leak as well. So you're leaking both ways by that point.
Yeah, because your periods are gushing, you're leaking this way, you're leaking that way. I'm guessing the bladders and the bowels, how's that?
Bladders and
that
bowels
work?
Take a beating.
Yeah, they do. The bladder, like, unless
you
do Kegels.
Yeah,
unless you do Kegels.
So as moms who've done this now more than once, And I assume, going by what I've seen of your relationships and your kids and all, that you have excellent husbands. Let's say that for the camera. You watch this show and decide to see me. I think what is important for young husbands to know? What do you think?
Not to put pressure on their wives, like to get back into a normal, you know, sex, to get their sex life back on track. Because I think I've brought this up with both of you, especially when you're breastfeeding, your libido, it vanishes.
For the third, I went numb. I'm like stuck in this pose and I'm going numb, I can't push, I can't hold, someone hold my hand, because I couldn't grip anything to push. And then, you know, in your head, you're like, am I going to die? Is my whole body shutting down? What the hell is happening? Yeah, oh, but yes. It was like I couldn't even grip to push. Like, it was dead scary. But then that's the time the husband needs to step in, and he needs to know that whole process and what happens. So it's like really important you take mm-hmm. him for that first visit to the guy, when mm-hmm. the guy explains this is what's going on, and the ultrasound visits, and basically he needs to be there.
Having gone through all that, right, it's like an entire movie-like epic journey of getting pregnant, having the baby, and then getting over that. What possesses you to go through it the second time?
Who knows, right? Your sex body forgets about it.
Like, what does it feel like to know, okay, now you finally maybe got your body back to whatever semblance of normalcy, and you're back in action, and then find out that you're pregnant again. What does that do?
You're not looking forward to it, because my third was a complete accident, right?
Yeah.
It's like, first you wonder, am I pregnant? And then when it hits you, you're like, okay, I can't breathe now. Here we go again.
Is that a number three?
No. I also get the, well, what about a girl? You know, so no. Because what if it's not a girl? I can't handle another boy. I just can't.
Yeah, I'm there now.
And it's not just the boy part. It's the whole getting pregnant, the pregnancy, the birth, the breastfeeding, the toddler years, the newborn. The diapers.
The
feeding.
The getting peed on. Yeah. The wiping meconium. Mm-hmm.
I have no doubts that motherhood is quite the experience, right? With all of that, I don't think you would ever reconsider.
No.
If you were to do it all over again, would you do anything differently?
No.
Excuse me?
That's gotta go, right? Perfect timing.
Don't worry, darling.
What does that say?
It's just the oven.
It's just the oven, don't press it. Can you go upstairs? We're about to finish up now.
We're gonna eat some cake. If the water breaks,
oh, right. And it comes out, then you gotta call someone, like if I'm unable to. Someone hold it.
All right.
No, you can take it.
Anish, you need to move.
You got into the new.
2,000 years later.
What should women be talking about if when you're preparing for things that
don't worry about your body?
A lot of women obsess over the changes that take place in their bodies.
Yeah.
And like during pregnancy and after, right? Both.
No, I mean, it is a shift. You're one size and then you're about 10 size bigger, and then you're supposed to get back to that one size. But sometimes you never do, because like...
And a lot of that is because of pressure from others also, right? Look at you, what happened to you? Mm. You should have lost the weight.
You're bigger now, like I'm getting the yotina now. Are you eating? Yeah. Are you...
You can never win.
Took up
the stretch marks.
Which is sometimes it's all over the tummy. Mm. I have like, on my sides. I don't worry about it.
Yeah. I mean, those are your battle scars, right?
Yeah,
like I've done this and
they kind of fade eventually.
Yep.
Yeah.
And I honestly think any woman who has undergone what you described, right, and gone through that, I would say, physical war with her body, and
then given
birth, and is raising the next generation of people, and is also keeping a husband in place and taking care of like the whole world, I think that person she's entitled to have whatever body she's in.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching. Did you like the episode? If you did, subscribe now below and share the link with everyone you know to get this conversation going. We also have a weekly column in the morning newspaper, and that's every Sunday morning. And you can join in on the conversation online, offline. Did you get that also? Yeah.